everything about me. I've lived a lot of lives. Before I was an Avenger. Before I got this family. I made mistakes. Choosing between what the world wants you to be. And who you are.
Efter godt 2 års ventetid er Marvel Studios endelig tilbage med et nyt kapitel i selskabets mægtige superheltesaga.
We have unfinished business.
I filmen gentager Scarlett Johansson titelrollen som den russiske forhåndværende snigmorder Black Widow.
You were everything.
Black Widow har optrådt i talrige Marvel-film i årenes løb, men nu får hun altså endelig lov til at dominere rampelyset. Og det gør hun i en tip-top thriller, der buner af solid action og pragtfulde præstationer.
Here's what's gonna happen.
Natasha, don't slouch.
I'm not slouching.
You're going to get the back hunch.
Listen to your mother.
Oh my god, this...
Up, listen.
All right, enough, all of you.
I didn't say anything, that's not fair.
Og vi har talt med 2 af filmens skuespillere, David Harbour og O.T. Fackbenlay. Og vi lægger ud med vores snak med Harbour. Den enormt karismatiske skuespiller har haft et væld af forskellige roller gennem karrieren, men han er nok bedst kendt for rollen som sheriffen Jim Hopper i Stranger Things.
99 out of 100 times kid goes missing. The kid is with a parent or a relative.
What about the other time?
What?
You said 99 out of 100. What about the other time? The one! The one!
I Black Widow spiller Harbour den afdankede russiske supersoldat Red Guardian, som kæmper side om side med filmens slagkraftige heltinde.
Just don't make a scene. You made a scene, didn't you?
What is with this tension?
I couldn't help but wonder or think, and this might sound a bit pretentious, but I felt like your performance was really emblematic for me of why these Marvel films are so successful, because It's delightfully over the top, and it's so funny, but it never really crosses that line between levity and laughable. You know, it doesn't become a parody of itself. It doesn't become unrelatable. So is that a really difficult balancing act, you know, playing such a flamboyant, you know, loud Russian, you know, superhero, and then still keeping, you know, a semblance of reality and groundedness in your performance?
Yeah. I mean, I think you have a lot of help, though, too, in Kate Shortland, in the editors, in the writers. But yes, it is kind of a balancing act. I mean, and I think that I think Kate plays all of us as different instruments in that ensemble. I think for some people, you know, maybe for some of the more serious actors who are amazing, maybe it is playing up that comedy. Whereas with me, hambone than I am, it was more about really grounding the performance all the way through. And I love the fact that Kate is such a deep person and making such a deep movie that she was always steering the comedy towards coming out of a place of pain and need to connection, you know, a real deeply psychological place, as opposed to just being funny. And I think that you're right. It really, you need to have that. Otherwise, it does become kind of parody. But I'm glad you found that, because I also, you know, think that the movie does succeed on that level, and it is a hard tightrope to walk, but Marvel does it better than anybody. And so, you know, I am very pleased that you think that, and it's great that we achieved that.
It still fits.
Oh my god.
I never washed it once.
Come and drink.
Rise, you workers of salvation. Da, 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 da. Family. Back together again.
Speaking of those tightropes, I guess wrangling is such a Russian accent must also be a bit of a tightrope as well. Also, you know, there are some greats to look up to, you know, Gary Oldman in Air Force One.
I will execute a hostage every half an hour.
All on red heat.
Move your piece of shit called L out now or give me $50.
I do not understand. Huligani.
And John Malkovich in Rounders, of course, is one of the big ones.
So, that's it then. Just like a young man coming in for a quickie.
Did you draw any inspiration from any of those guys?
Yeah, I mean, a little bit, yeah. But it's more, you know, it's more personal, just my relationship to Russia and to what... A lot of it starts from the character place of, like, who is this Russian guy? And he really is a Soviet. And to me, he does have a big heart in the way of like a Chekhov character or like a Dostoevsky character. You know, these big Russian hearts and these big spirits. And you know, that comes in the way he carries himself. And then there's a dialect coach that comes in and you kind of build it from there. But yeah, I mean, I remember thinking about Malkovich in Rounders and, you know, in certain scenes, he is successful, and in certain scenes, maybe not as successful with that accent. It's a tricky accent. It's a very tricky accent.
It's a fucking joke anyway.
Natasha, you're not just a spy, but an avenger. I couldn't be more proud of you.
You smell really bad.
In terms of not only the accent, but also just the look of the character, which I love. But that suit just looks so tight. I mean, how was that to also just yeah. to fight in it? Was that difficult?
It was fun. Like, I wanted him to be this big Russian bear. You know, they talk about like the great bear of Russia. So it's like, I wanted this hair and like this hair and the beard and like the, you know, just this violence. He's just very loud and then big, how big he was. Like, I wanted him to feel formidable, but not manicured in a way that, like, you know, big, muscly, like eats what he wants when he didn't give a damn. And then, yeah, the suit actually fits extremely well and feels extremely good. They did give me an extra tight one for that particular scene that I think we all know, you know, he has trouble fitting in. I had a couple extra like donuts at lunch too that day. I remember that was, you know, cause you know, you just don't, you want it to be as little acting as possible.
Yeah.
But the suit is actually amazing. They print out a 3D version of your body and they sculpt it to that model. So, and then the wearability, I mean, they've just gotten so good at it over the years. I wonder if it, I don't think it started this way, but they're so good at it now. It's like the way it moves and the way it breathes, it feels so comfortable. Like, it feels like this great onesie. I would wear it all the time if they gave it to me.
Cool. Well, David, I've got to round off, sadly, but it's been a pleasure. And just want to say quickly, after having watched that beautiful Architectural Digest video with you and really appreciating the Masses of the Universe poster.
It has Frank Langella in a ton of prosthetics as a Skeletor.
I'm kind of hoping that you would be cast as He-Man or Skeletor in the next movie, because they're still casting for those parts. That would be awesome.
Are they?
So, yeah.
All right. Yeah. Maybe we'll get somebody to make a call. Thank you.
Fingers crossed.
No!
Bagefter sludrer vi med britiske O.T. Fagbenlay. I de seneste år har han blandt andet brilleret i tv-serier som Looking og The Handmaid's Tale.
She's been captured. That's confirmed.
Wait, is she alive?
Yes.
I Black Widow spiller Fagbenlay den gådefulde og kække agent Mason, som hjælper Black Widow med at skaffe alskens dingenoter og våben, der kan hjælpe i kampen mod skurkene.
I take exception to impugning my professionalism.
Well, he did set me up with a generator that crapped out after 6 hours.
You too, huh?
Aw, he's sensitive. See why you keep him around.
Fagbenlays navn kommer fra hans nigerianske rødder, og det er ofte et samtaleemne, når manden bliver interviewet.
And O.T. Fagbenlay plays her husband. O.T. joins us now to discuss. Welcome,
thanks
O.T.
a lot. Good job on the last name, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Men da vi taler med Fagbenlay over Zoom, er det i stedet udtalelsen af en anden skuespillers navn, som han gerne vil diskutere.
I want to ask you something really quick, because... You're Johan, Scarlett, say Scarlett's name, say Scarlett's full name.
Scarlett Johansson?
So you say Johansson, and it's only imbecile people who say Johansson, right?
Oh, that's yeah, that's wrong. Right. Yeah. It's yeah, because she actually, the funny thing is she both has Swedish and Danish roots. So I think her grandfather is Danish.
But both those cultures both say Johansson.
Yeah, we would say Johansson normally.
Johansson.
Yeah.
Listen, from now on, it's Johansson.
Exactly. But I'm really glad to talk to you, because I really enjoyed your part in this film. I thought the film is extremely entertaining as well, and I couldn't help but get like a bit of a Q vibe from your part, you know, in terms of the sassy comebacks, you know, the procurement of cool gadgets.
I thought you were supposed to be the best, like a real pro.
Oh, I beg your pardon, Serena. Was the free flat and lifetime supply of Kissel not to your liking?
Huh. Ejector seat, you're joking.
I never joke about my work, 007.
I guess it's not too shabby to be the Q of the Marvel Universe.
No, and it needed one. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, before Mason turned up, you tell me if you know better, who was the closest person to a Q? Like,
that's true.
Exactly.
They just had their gadgets. We never knew where they came from. So you've been pulling the strings in the background ever since the beginning, you know?
Poor Iron Man, you know what I mean? He's doing all he can. He needs some help. So now I'm here. So relax, everybody. There's a solution.
Yeah. But I mean, I love your character, but of course, I still have to ask, like, because the movie has so many deliciously colorful, over-the-top characters. Now, you're one of the few who doesn't get to put on a shiny leotard and do some martial arts. Were you disappointed in that?
They did put a leotard on me, and they were like, no, take it off of him, put him in something else, because that looks ridiculous. Listen, I mean, when someone tells you you're going to be in a Marvel movie and you're going to be playing opposite Scarlett Johansson and you're going to get to, like, you know, you don't complain. You don't look a gift horse in the mouth is what we say in England. So, no, I was happy. I'm happy. But I did do some fighting training. So if I'm ever needed in the future to, like, take people, I mean, it's a one-handed because I'm holding a coffee, but you can see I don't
I don't want to spill your coffee, but I mean, yeah. Speaking of the future, I mean, I just assume when people do these Marvel movies, you sign up for like a bunch of movies. Do you have an inkling of an idea of what the future holds for the MCU and you in it?
This happens to be one of the things, they give you a piece of paper of things you're not allowed to talk about. And on that piece of paper, it's this very question. So,
okay.
I'm going to have to take a sip.
So I'm going to put on, when I edit this together, I'm going to put on the alarms from QI. when I ask the question, yes. You just mentioned Scarlett Johansson, of course. You have so many lovely little scenes where I love how the dialogue of your scenes almost has this improvisational feel. And you actually have my favorite line in the film, I'm not made of jets. I love that. That was just that was so spiky.
I said we needed a jet.
Yeah, you know what you didn't give me? Time or money. I'm not made of jets.
But how was she to work with? Because, of course, there's so much pressure on her as a producer and with this part and having, you know, finally being the solo character.
Yeah, you know what? It's some things I think about sometimes because it's easy to forget that someone's under so much immense pressure. But she's very relaxed and chilled and kind of like, but really professional and present and stuff like that. So just a dream to work with, really.
I made my choice. I'm done running.
Are those books or are those DVDs?
They are, it's Blu-rays and DVDs.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I have about 3,000 of them.
Do you have any Marvel movies in there?
I have all of them, of course. I even have them. I have them in a huge glass box, you know, in limited 4K editions. Of course, that's the kind of geek that I am. Of course.
Wow, love it.
Yeah, so really looking forward to adding Black Widow to my collection as well. So, hello there, OT. Hello,
Johan. What's good? Are those DVDs or CDs behind you?
They are almost exclusively Blu-rays. All of them. Actually, about 3,000 of them.
You're about this life. I respect it.
I know. I moved in here recently and the moving guy was like, let me send you a link to something called Netflix. Because I had 25 moving boxes just with movies. You know?
You get the added extras with the Blu-ray.
Exactly.
Tell that guy to get out of your face. He doesn't know what he's talking about.